Here we go with some red, white and blue, a prime of the smoke system. Smoke off go, and then the engine's now wound up. Each of the sections will set slightly different temperatures on the engine. So the front setting 630 degrees turbine gas temperature, 635 for the middle section, and 640 for red sticker section at the back.
Rolling.
Now the brakes are released, reds 1, 2 and 3 start rolling, half a second later reds 4 and 5, and 1.5 seconds after red 1 you'll see red 6, 7, 8 and 9 start to roll along the runway. The aircraft accelerate quickly using that Rolls-Royce Azure engine, already doing around 70 knots by the time they reach the front of the chalet. The nose wheel comes off at 100 knots. Leader, squad leader David Montenegro. His first year as the team leader. He is a former Hawk instructor and Tornado F3 air defence pilot. Started off with the Red Arrows in fact in 2009 through to 2011 and ended up leading the synchro pair.
6, 4, 5, 8, 9.
Here now red 4, 5, 8 and 9. Acknowledge another move, and you'll see red 6 and 7 move from the stem, that middle section of the shape, they move to their respective sides. Reds 8 and 9 have moved to the outside now, and this formation now, measuring from left tip to right tip, is 100 metres or 300 feet wide. They're going to lay down some very patriotic red, white and blue. This is Phoenix. On the Hawk aircraft before then moving to fly the Harrier GR9 and then the Tornado GR4 before he joined the Red Arrows this year. Another shape now, reds 8 and 9 have moved back behind reds 4 and 5, they're coming in from the right, they're going to fly a formation barrel roll in the shape of chevron. Cameras ready now as they come in from the right to fly the chevron roll.
Rolling. Ow. Listening. Out.
All nine jets going upside down, 400 miles an hour, 2,500 feet above us. The closest part for those aircraft being only around 6 feet away from each other. Fly this formation with red one clearly at the front in the middle, the odd-numbered pilots on the left, and the even-numbered pilots fly on the right. And in their three-year tour with the team, pilots generally start at the front near the leader, and as their proficiency improves, they move further back. And on the leader's left wing now is the next of our new pilots. He is red three, Flight Lieutenant Emmett Cox. Emmett was actually brought up in New Zealand, but he moved to the UK in 2002 to join the Royal Air Force, becoming a Tornado GR4 pilot and then an instructor on the Tucano, teaching basic fast jet training. Smoke's on front left now as we form another shape. And we've just seen a fabulous Balmo of Battle of Britain aircraft. We've introduced this shape this year to honour all of those who in the summer of 1940 worked to secure our skies. And we're here to honour those people from 1940, but also to honour all of those who secure our skies in the present. In from the left now, the smoke's about to come on. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Spitfire.
Hold it now, fight. Now, fight.
Hey. Imagine a Spitfire thing there to honour those who secure our skies. But it wasn't just a few, the fighter pilots back in the day who worked to make sure our skies were secure. Everybody in the Royal Air Force had their part to play. Whether they were plotters, observers, mechanics, controllers, administrators, everybody had their part to play. And it's no different today. The Royal Air Force operates on the whole force concept, using regulars, reserves, civil servants, contractors, and every trade and rank to make sure that we can deliver our output. But now in from the left, ladies and gentlemen, camera's ready. This is our trademark shape. It's diamond. The very lowermost aircraft that we see now is flown by the last of our new pilots this year. He is Red 5, he is flight lieutenant Tom Moles. Tom started his career as an instructor on the Tucano aircraft, teaching basic passenger training. In fact, he also just played the Tucano back in 2010. Then he moved on to the Royal Air Force Typhoon, the newest fighter in our fleet, where his role is exactly what I've just been talking about. Primary role of the UK's Typhoon Force is to secure the skies. The force is on at readiness 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days of the year. That's exactly what Tom was doing on quick reaction alert on the Typhoon Force. Tom would like to say hello today to his mum and dad, seeing him wait for the first time. So hello to David and Jackie. In from the right now, slightly wider diamond. This is a new manoeuvre for 2015, and this is the Whirlwind. Left-hand control column input, and that rolls the aircraft rapidly around its longitudinal axis. The key to the Whirlwind is getting all of the aircraft doing it at exactly the same time.
Stop on! Stop. Two, three.
Out to the left now, we're going to collapse from that very wide shape into a very small shape. We designed the display, so these shape changes actually form part of the show itself. And you can see that shape taking form now. Back in the 70s and 80s, there was a very fast US spy plane. Sadly, it's now out of service. The fastest warplane ever built. It was known officially as the SR-71. The shape the boys have formed now, and it's Blackbird.
Rolling. Out. And pulling. Up.
Pulling up now at 4G in Blackbird. At 400 miles an hour. Yet another shape change happening now as the aircraft reached 6,000 feet. Slowed down now to about 150 miles an hour at the top of this loop. The G's backed off to around 1G. You can see that very obvious shape of a feathered arrow. As they start coming down the other side of the hill, the speed's building back up to around 400. They're going to twist this now. The G's building up 2G, 3G, 4G as they start the left-hand turn and show us feathered arrow or red. Well, that's the end of the first half of the Red Arrow display, ladies and gentlemen. So far, you've seen all nine aircraft together performing close formation aerobatics. Well, now we're going to split down in a section of 2, 3, 4, 5, or 7 aircraft. I'll show you some more dynamic manoeuvring. Overhead the BA systems hangar, you see a big T-shaped formation. That's known as Dagger. And at the front of Dagger are Res 1 to 5. Collectively known as Enid, after Enid Blyton's famous 5. And at the back of the line are Red 6, 7, 8 and 9. That formation is known as Jippo. Jippo was the nickname of the gentleman who first led the back four aircraft when the Red Arrow started officially flying 9 ship displays back in 1968. The Dagger's about to roll out directly towards us, and it's definitely time to get your cameras ready. They're bringing it round at around 3G to point directly here at the airfield. You'll soon see those nose lights point straight towards you. Cameras ready to start the second half of the display. The smoke's about to come on.
Smoke on.
The smoke comes on as we get ready for the detonator. Enid split at the top. Now keep your eyes on Jippo underneath. By Red 9. These four aircraft are descending just 100 feet above the runway. They're now closing at 800 miles an hour. Cameras ready. This is the fabulous Jippo Pass. Now leave their smoke on. They are turning away from us now. They're putting 6G or 6 times the force of gravity. Everything in these pilots' bodies now weighs 6 times more than normal, so they're working hard to fight the G-force. They roll out now and fly the Cyclone. Now the captain and the captain are being joined That's him just joining at the back now.
And Colin.
Pulling up now at 4G in a shape called Vixen.
Right now.
Red 1 is now twisting this loop towards us through 90 degrees in a quarter clover. Cameras ready as they come out of the clouds. This is the vertical break. Red 6, his voice is pushing minus 2.5G. He's now the right way up, the other three are the wrong way up as they fly the mirror roll. Minus 2.5G, very uncomfortable, I can tell you from experience. Looking out left now. Inside pairs roll to the outside as they fly the rollbacks. Now roll upside down.
8 and 9,
now rolling around them is the corkscrew. Benefit. They're going to draw a red, white and blue snake-like shape of smoke in the sky. Now inverted as they fly, the python. Aircraft's 400 degree engine exhaust and makes it vaporize. To get the red and blue color, we add a dye to the diesel. We can carry 5 minutes of white smoke, a minute each of red and blue in each of the aircraft. Looking up, Reds 8 and 9 pitch up to roll around 6 and 7. They then roll before they get ready to split. Cameras ready for this ship home break. Double rolls. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the synchro pair. The Royal Air Force Aerobatic Team, the Red Arrows. Red One, in from the right, performing the battle break. Miles an hour, they've got to idle on the engines, the air brakes have come out, they're putting 60, here comes Red One, a little blip of smoke. You'll see we've got a wind from the left, so the odd number pilots landing on a shallow stack, the even number pilots landing on a steep stack, and there's that smoke. Landing with 2,000 feet in between each aircraft, and landing at around 120 knots, or around about 150 miles an hour. Hawks only got little wheels, therefore the brakes are not very effective at those sort of speeds. So we're slowing down using the headwind and the nice long 9,000 foot runway here at RIAT. And as they come past the main fresh and RIAT enclosure, the grandstand, they'll be down at about 100 knots before they come to a stop towards the end of the runway. So now, ladies and gentlemen, in from the right, the rest of the guys will be landing. I'll leave you to watch them. Please wave as they go past. Hope you'll speak to some of you again tomorrow. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you very much for watching and for listening. I'll hand you back to Ben. I wish you all the very best for everybody at the Red Arrow. Thank you, Lingy. Lovely stuff. And we look forward to seeing you in the air on both show days, including an appearance with another aircraft, the conversation for which joins me now, Sean Matter, who this year was very privileged to have been awarded the Special Chairman's Prize by the Air Force Council, their convention in Antwerp. Sean, welcome.
Well, thank you very much. She's off down to the right, approximately where the Red Arrows are, quite a long way down to the right. You can see the aircraft there, and the rather close by. And when she's one of only two air shows in the year when she does actually, she is actually on the air. It seems that you can see underwing tour, which is very popular. Guided tour and seems to be to cover the wheels and all that stuff.